Hi, my name is Christian Steinmetz, and I'm a master's student at Universitat Pompeu Fabra in Barcelona, studying sound and music computing. Today, I want to talk about flowEQ, a plugin I built with MATLAB to expand the way in which audio engineers interface with the parametric equalizer. The equalizer is one of the foundational tools used by audio engineers to shape the timbre of a sound recording. The parametric equalizer is unique in that it gives the user control over the filter shape and center frequency of each band of the equalizer. While this makes it a very powerful tool, it requires experience to fully grasp how to utilize it to achieve the desired timbral effect. The goal of flowEQ is to provide an interface to this tool that does not require the user to have a deep understanding of the EQ parameters. This way, novice users can intuitively move through relevant settings using their ears to guide the process. In addition, this provides an efficient modality for experienced engineers to explore the space of timbral profiles and even implement time-varying timbral effects that would otherwise be challenging to implement. In order to create an intelligent interface for the parametric equalizer, we apply dimensionality reduction with the use of a disentangled variational autoencoder. An autoencoder is comprised of two functions, an encoder and decoder. The encoder takes a high-dimensional input, in our case, the value of the 13 knobs from the parametric equalizer. This function maps these values to a lower-dimensional space, which we call the latent space. The decoder then tries to reconstruct the original input with knowledge only of the low-dimensional code. During training, we measure the difference between the original and reconstructed parameters, and we use this to update the weights of the encoder and decoder networks until convergence. To make this model useful, we employ the decoder as a generative model. We can then easily sample points from the latent space and generate new sets of parameters that represent relevant configurations of the equalizer. A variational autoencoder, or VAE, is an extension of this concept that introduces some desirable properties. Unlike the simple autoencoder, it attempts to map each input to a Gaussian distribution within the latent space. We encourage this behavior by adding a new term to the loss function, known as the KL divergence. This centers the latent codes around the origin, forces similar samples to be placed near each other, and ensures that the latent space is more densely populated. All desirable qualities for our model when we want to generate new samples. Finally, we make one further adjustment. We adjust the relative weights of the reconstruction and KL losses. This factor, known as beta, allows us to control the disentanglement within the latent space. Greater disentanglement means we are closer to encoding a single property along a single dimension of the latent space. For more details on the math and intuition behind the VAE, make sure to check out the project website. To implement the VAE, the Python deep learning library Keras was used. After training, model weights were saved and loaded into a custom MATLAB class that implements the math needed to construct the decoder. In order to provide additional control to the user, 12 different models were trained. This includes models with 1, 2, and 3-dimensional latent spaces, each at 4 different values of beta, to investigate different levels of disentanglement. The user can then select among these models within the plugin. The plugin features 3 main modes of operation: traverse, semantic, and manual. These provide different means to interact with the trained models. In traverse mode, the user can directly sample from the latent space with the X, Y, and Z sliders. The number of sliders that are active is based upon the number of latent dimensions in the selected model. Enabling the extend mode allows for more points to be explored in the latent space. In semantic mode, the user can select from predetermined points within the latent space that have semantic meaning. The interpolate slider provides a way to smoothly move between the two selected semantic descriptors. Additionally, an automatic gain compensation mode is included. This is helpful when comparing different timbres. There are 3 main applications of flowEQ. First, we will look at using flowEQ on the stems within a multitrack mix.
Passing through the clouds of my soul, would that I shine looking down, cracked, I fear, and I know that's so. Yes, I know.
Another application of the plugin is as simple yet powerful tone controls on program material. Here we will look at applying flowEQ on a fully produced track. Finally, there is potential to use flowEQ for creative effects. For example, we can seamlessly vary the timbre of an electric guitar over time in a more sophisticated manner than simply varying the cutoff frequency of a single filter.
Thank you.
Thanks for watching this video. To download the plugin for Windows or Mac OS, please visit the project website. Source code for the plugin and training of the neural networks is also available on the GitHub repository.